Hello sir, welcome to Tech Magnifier.
Thank you.
Okay, today we have with us Amit Gujral, who is head of marketing for LG smartphones. Sir, let's start this conversation with this question that company's smartphone business and market share. So tell us about like its expansion plans and marketing strategies for India.
LG smartphones has been doing pretty well. Because once we took a very serious call 2 years back that we will sell only smartphones, then on we have never looked back. We have been growing month on month, and as I speak, we have been operating out of 130 cities in the country as of now, and the plan going forward would be to cover 200 cities in the country. And the ultimate marketing strategy, if I talk about, first and foremost thing is we want to excite our consumers with a wonderful experience what they get through our devices. And I think with the kind of phones we have launched in the recent past, the G2, the G Pro Lite, the Nexus series of 4 and 5, G Flex, and now the L series 3 with lots of innovative features, I think the consumer experience is the key focus area for us. So once you visit our stores, you will find we have live demo experience zones exclusive for our smartphones at variety of stores.
Right. Can you be a little specific about market share you're expecting by the end of 2014-15?
I think the kind of lineup we have and the kind of support we are getting from the market, we should be exiting 2014 with 10% market share in smartphones.
10% market share?
That's right.
So, okay. So, what are you doing to improve the situation?
As I said, the prime focus is to bring about the devices which truly are in line to consumer needs.
So do you see things changing with LG G2 and Flex?
Oh, tremendously, yes. Not only G2 and G Flex. There has been a very, very positive response to our L Series 2, which we launched last year. And we are upbeat again with our L Series 3, with the recent launches of L90 and L70.
You came up with many innovative ideas and features like knock code, knock on. Briefly explain how it helps end customers.
As I spoke earlier also sometimes, that our philosophy towards smartphone is all about bringing alive consumer needs via the user experience we bestow on our phones. So when it talks about innovation, it's all about our attempt to serve consumer needs in most simple manner. For example, you spoke about the G2 rear key, right? Index finger has been the most used finger on your phone, if you just recall yourself when you use the phones. Right. So we gave to the world the rear key, and response has been so positive that we moved on with rear key on the G Pro 2 upcoming. Similarly, to keep your phone more secure, we present to you the knock code, a very simple to use security feature, where on a phone screen, a blank screen, you just have to tap your code, which is invisible. Nobody can make out what the code you have tapped, which is not dependent on which part of the screen you tap. That's another beauty. Unlike your pattern locks, unlike your numeric locks, which people can see and copy. So here is the kind of innovation happening at LG Mobiles.
So do we get these features on budget phones as well?
Of course, yes. For example, when I talk about L90, L70, the world's first sub 20,000 phones with KitKat operating system do have the knock code.
LG is supposed to come with knock code and knock code coming to G2 and G Flex in April. So, is it true?
We are working on bringing alive the knock code on G2 and G Flex. As I spoke already to lot many people, we do not bring any upgrades or any updates to the phone without thoroughly testing them. And we test them in all possible situations of the prevailing country. Right? So, the work is on, and pretty soon we will announce the availability of knock code on G2 and G Flex as well.
Presently, sir, LG G Flex comes with Android 4.2 operating system. So, will it be upgradable to 4.4 KitKat for Indian market in near future?
Indeed, yes.
And what about LG GPad 8.3 tablet? When can we expect this tablet in Indian market?
GPad 8.3 precisely, we have not lined up for India as of now, and we don't see GPad 8.3 bringing to India anytime soon as such.
Okay, may I know the reason, sir? I mean, why not in India?
There's no specific reason for the device. The only reason is with we bringing and lot of people bringing a large screen size smartphones, 5.5 inches, 6 inches phones. The usage is very dimming between so-called phablet and a tablet. So the work is on to really realize the consumer needs purely from a tablet standpoint. So as of now, we don't see market is very upbeat on tablet per se.
Actually, we customers, we actually expect LG to come up with some tablet this time. I mean, we have seen many innovative smartphones, but now we are expecting LG to launch with some tablet as well.
So if the world has seen LG with changing the game changing innovations on smartphones, I can only quote here that once we bring our tablet, it will be talking point in terms of the innovations.
As you said, game changing device, that means LG G Flex with flexible battery. But how successful it is in terms of market acceptability? How has been the response so far?
I think the game changing, when I say it, is not just G Flex. It started with G2, coming down to G Flex, and now the L series 3. Look at just a simple phenomena of having your most premium features available to you at a price point of 14,000 rupees. That's the kind of innovation we have, and that's what we call game changers, with features like rear key, flexible displays, curved batteries, and then your knock code, knock onto the world.
So don't you think so that LG G Flex is a little expensive for Indian users?
Not really. It is very easy saying that we have a flexible phone. When we know that the future is all about the wearable devices, a lot of R&D has been done by a lot of companies, and G Flex is the first answer to the world of what future can be. So the amount of effort and engineering and the technology involved to make a truly flexible smartphone with a plastic OLED, because if it's not plastic, you can't make it flexible. So the price point is absolutely in line with the kind of feature, functions, hardware, software the phone has.
So are you like planning to launch LG G Flex Mini?
We are not saying that it will be called G Flex Mini. There will be variants of G Flex in the time to come, and we got to see what we call them.
Okay, so there is a rumor of launching G3 mini variant, G2 mini variant. So how true is it?
Please don't believe our rumors.
Okay, and what type of like pricing strategies for your handset do you follow?
A very simple philosophy of pricing. Prices of the phones are truly proportional to the kind of feature, functions and hardware they offer to consumers.
Tell us about the designing part of all LG premium smartphones specifically. Like LG G Flex has self-healing back, full glossy plastic body, and last year you have launched Optimus G, which used a premium glass body, but this year you are back to glossy plastic with D2. So any experiment would you like to do with other phones as well?
Experiments, what I say again, are driven by our consumers. When we go back to them, that what kind of phones they want with what kind of hardware, that's what is the strategy we drive to deliver any new phone. Once again, I come back to the rear key. Nobody could have imagined how best to use index finger. Once again, I tell you about a curved flexible phone with G Flex. People have been imagining of curved phones, and here's the answer, right? Looking into our budget phones, if you closely watch L90, L70, they are having a unique design pattern of mesh at the back, which used to be phenomena of somebody else's high-end premium phones. We have brought down to a sub-20 price point. So innovations right from consumer experience to hardware is kind of continuous effort at LG.
Any comments on the rumor regarding the next Nexus smartphone by LG?
Only God or Google knows about it.
Okay. So, I mean, recently there is no plan as such.
I said only God or Google themselves know. Okay. When do they want to bring new Nexus.
Okay. So, like, we can't expect anything from LG right now.
LG has been giving you two Nexus back to back. So, we never know.
So the next Nexus may come soon.
I don't know. As I said, it is God or Google.
Okay. And apart from like bendable phone like G Flex, what else innovative ideas you're planning to come up with?
Oh well, there are lot many, and all driven by people like you. We talk to you, we hear millions of people, and I think it will be too early for me to quote anything in particular. But I think as we have come up with surprises. From G2 to G Flex.
So any hint you would like to give to our customers?
Think of more security, more innovations on camera, more innovation on using the phone itself.
Can I term this innovative feature knock code and knock on as a security feature?
It's your personal security feature, and it's best and uncomparable to any other security feature you can imagine of on a phone.
Sir, what's your roadmap for the Indian mobile device market in near future?
Roadmap is pretty simple. This market offers us to play across price points. with variety of different devices, variety of screen sizes, variety of processors. So we are aligned to the Indian market, and you will see the devices all across price points from LG.
And what about the tablet market? Will LG come with any tablet market in new?
As I spoke, we are studying. We are trying to uncover that thin line between phablet and tablet. And whenever LG brings a tablet, it would definitely be something to talk about.
Last but not the least, shed some light on the future of the smartphone in India by LG.
Pretty bright. Not only for LG, for the country itself, the smartphone future is very, very bright. And if you just closely watch the market movements, truly the growth among the mobile phones has come only in smartphones, right? So we will see a lot of variety of devices in terms of hardware form factors, in terms of software functionalities. A lot more will happen in this country.
Any message would you like to give to LG users, LG smartphone users?
Well, I would like to first of all say thanks. Thanks for using LG. And as we have never disappointed you with our innovations, look forward to more, and we would love to have you here with us for as long as possible.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your time. Thank you.
Thank you.
For latest news and reviews of gadget and games, visit www.techmagnifier.com.